Namaste.
Namaste, friends. Welcome. Welcome.
Finally, on Facebook, we are the right way around. We've been mirror image forever. And only today I figured it out how to turn that. But I don't know how to turn that on Instagram Live. So if somebody knows, I've Googled it, I couldn't find it. If somebody knows, please let me know.
Welcome to Deva's world. They're the kind of things.
Tech support.
Tech support. Wow. You guys, I feel like we're becoming deep friends. Friendship happening here. Amazing. And Deva said to me, oh, you know, maybe we should just come out of the swimming pool and just there's a pool here too, you know. We just got so lucky. You're all welcome. Any of you welcome to come and dip in our pool.
With safe spacing.
Yeah, well, I guess so, yeah. Well. And the little birds are in and out of the nest all day long now, protecting it. I'm sure soon we will see the little bird. As soon as we do, we will show to you, of course. Mm-hmm. I feel a little lighter today, as if there's some evidence that maybe the virus is slowing down, and soon we will be able to begin our new lives in a new paradigm and a new understanding with new perspectives, and with trust. I think trust is the most important thing, because trust implies that we accept that there is a force of some kind or a guide of some kind that leads us through this life, and the decisions we make are not very much to do with ourselves and our minds, that they are made for us in some very transcendent way.
Some people are saying they feel the same like you.
Yeah.
Something has shifted.
Something's shifted. Let's hope so. I don't really like to live in the world of hope. I don't really feel hope is something that I like to engage in somehow, but I understand hope for a better world, the sooner the better.
But maybe it's already begun, you know?
Yeah.
Like, not to say too soon we can begin our new lives.
Yeah, yeah.
But we've really begun our new life already, and whatever we are hatching in this period of incubation, in our incubation boxes that we find ourselves in. I'm sure you've heard this before. Bruce Lipton has put it so beautifully. Our friend Dapan has put it so beautifully about the caterpillar. And the caterpillar, the way I understand it, eats 300 times its body weight before it becomes a cocoon. And I think our human race has about eaten 300 times its body weight by now. I mean, because we are so overnourished on all levels. And then the caterpillar becomes this cocoon where it just becomes this liquid mush, you know, like for I don't know how long. And all the cells get rearranged. It's the same cells that make up the caterpillar that will make up the butterfly. They're reassigned, like the cells become different things, and there's even cells that are not needed anymore. They're all rearranged in this beautiful butterfly that emerges. And you know, this is really what the state we are in with our transition period where we are all in our cocoons, literally, and we're all rearranged, and we feel like, oh my God, where is this ever going to end? Am I ever going to become something again? Now I look around, it's all just a mess or a chaos or an undefined thing. And
which is what we're in now.
Yeah, totally. And the butterfly will emerge. When it emerges, it has its own perfect timing, and that
certainly
is not us, ours to know at this point.
That's certainly a rebirth happening. It's the first time ever on the planet that the whole humanity has been involved in one issue. Never happened ever. So indicates that it's a big situation what we're in.
Oh really?
Mm. it's pretty big.
Is it?
It's pretty big. You know, it's funny. You know what? Do you know we have about 300 muscles in our face? And I was reading this the other day. Who was I?
Thich Nhat Hanh.
Oh, the Buddhist, the beautiful Buddhist monk. He was saying, you know, that we should do face yoga and smile. It's very, if we don't smile, our muscles, they're not used. And to smile consciously is important, and it's something we can all be encouraged to do. Even there's so many different ways to smile, and there's so many different smiles that mean different things. So I would like to encourage you to look for that inner smile that I feel is located down in our bellies, in our soul, in our second chakra. That's where I feel it. Feels like that's where the power of gratitude actually is. I don't know if that's the way it is, but that's the way I feel that second chakra. No, the smile is deep. It's deep. It's deep down. It's like the Gayatri. It's really down, deep, dark red, crimson depth to it, you know. And that's where that inner smile is. A smile for no reason.
Yeah.
No reason, you know. That's what we're looking for. That's what we're singing for. That's what we're chanting for. It's to smile for no reason. And to sing is to heal. So, would you like to sing a round of Ampona?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so shall we begin with our meditation? And lighten your candles. Lighting the incense, bringing your children into the meditation and your pets. Let's be together as one. And, okay, we settle down. Our body's comfortable. Feeling from the inside. And we're closing our eyes, so now we begin to feel the body from the inside. We're checking to see if we're comfortable, if our legs feel good, if we want to change anything in the way that we are positioned. And bringing our awareness to our spine, so we straighten the spine and relax the shoulders. And take a deep breath in this space. Still point. And before we begin our meditation today, which we will be chanting the mantra Om as usual in rhythm with Deva, so we're all in rhythm together all over the world, and then we will chant the Gayatri mantra, invoking the light into our lives, and then we will complete the meditation with the mantra Om. If you can manage to do with your eyes closed, just to internalize, it makes your visit to your home, and I'm talking about our home inside ourselves, easier and deeper and more comfortable. So see if you can just enjoy a moment where you just sit in meditation. meditation. We will chant with you and for you. You can bring your awareness to the sounds that are around you and connecting with that deep inner smile for no reason. And they will begin the mantra with the Om Purnam invocation.
Ah.
Yeah. To make the sound resonate that in your body. Leave plenty of breath for the
Purnamudachyate. Purnasya purnamadaya. Purnamevavashishyate. Purnasya purnamadaya purnamevavashishyate.
song called Exactly As It Is. I think we can manage this one. The flame in my heart, it burns for you, my love, like a river burning red at the close of day. With yours side by side, no, I had no choice, I simply love you that way. And it's like that, it's like this, it's exactly as it is. It's a natural affair, there's no mystery there. It's exactly as it is. I simply love you. Blessed sun, it shines for you, my beloved one, shining on this river that's burning red at the close of day. Yes, I've seen that river so still, seen it roaring in flood. You are the river running in my blood, and I rejoice that I have loved you this way, this way. It's like that, and it's like this, it's exactly as it is. Yes, it's a natural affair, no mystery there. It's exactly Yeah.
Namaste.
Namaste, everyone.
We will end with our blessing. May all beings be happy. May all beings be free. May all my thoughts, words, and actions contribute in some way to the happiness and freedom of all beings. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu.
Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Hari Namaste.